everyone, this is Nick, and I'm just here with a really quick Excel tip for when you are working with some of your survey data in Excel, and maybe you've analyzed some of it, and you know, the export comes out on these big columns and rows. This is a sample data set that we use for how to analyze select all that apply data. The link to that video is above. And you might see here, we have a few things. So these are all of my survey data. This is my survey responses here in column A. I have summed down each column to see how many people have selected each of these options on my select all that apply question. So these cells right here have sum formulas equals sum down the column. And then these are percentage calculations. So this just says equals this cell divided by 22, because I know I have 22 people in my sample. So 23% of people selected blueberry from my list, 64% selected orange, etc. So this is a nice way to sort of summarize your data. But what if you need to sort of give it in a better summary table that you just want to email really quickly to your boss, to whoever asks for it? I just wanted to show you this really quick trick where you can switch columns and rows really easily in Excel with a little paste special magic. So what I'm going to do right here is I'm going to highlight this column, this row right here, so all of those cells. I'm going to hold down the control key. When you hold down the control key, that will allow you to then highlight another row that's not exactly below the one that you just highlighted. So we're going to do this, and I'm going to click on my sum and percentage row here and drag down. So now you see that all three of those are selected. I'm going to push control C to copy, and now we want to transpose this into a nice summary table over here. So I'm going to say right here, I'm going to right click in this cell, I'm gonna go to paste special, and we're gonna click on this little option right here. I like to just open this paste special button right here. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna say, I'm gonna click on this little transpose button right here. And then I'm gonna also click on values and number formats. I want it just to give me the values and the number formats. I don't want it to give me the formulas that it's using to pull those data from. So I'm gonna click on that. We're gonna click okay. And now you see I have this really nice summary table right here that just popped up. I can go ahead and just edit that text right here. You can see that it's in a nice summarized format, our options right here for our responses, the number of people, and the percentage that I got right from my analysis down here on the sheet. So it's a really quick tip. Use that paste special transpose to make your tables a little bit more readable when you are just sending them to your stakeholders or whoever you need to read some of that data. Really quick tip, but it's really fun. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a like and subscribe. Make sure to hit the bell next to it, and you'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.